So we're here at A1 Comics.
I don't know.
And it's, what? 24-hour comic book day? Or is it 4-hour comic book day? We're doing 4-hour comic book day. So I thought it was an opportunity to give you guys some more tips. Today's tips are going to be 5 tips on... say 5 tips for new comic book creators. So if you're new to comic books, something you've been interested in, and you're not sure where to start, these are going to be the tips for you. So my name is Eli Beard. I'm an artist for Scattered Comics. So I've created several comic books. I've created Alien 101, volumes 1, 2, and 3. 4 is on the way. Should be out next month. Dog of the Dead, written by Maxwell Shepard, illustrated by me. Very fun story. Also self-contained. I also created Action Land, books 1, 2, and 3. Book 4 should be out this year as well. So, I've been making comic books since 2008, when I first graduated high school. Well, I guess back before that. I first started creating comic books back in middle school, just casually, just to show friends. 2008, I decided to create an actual series. And then 2014, decided to take it seriously, rebooted my stories, and created these current stories. And I'm very proud of where they are now. So, my philosophy is that you should, when you're creating comic books, you should draw from what you know. Take your own experience, take something you're passionate about, and put that into your narrative. A lot of the mistake people make is thinking that their life's boring or their interests would be boring, but it's just boring to you because you live in it. They're usually very valuable and informative to other people that don't live your life. So that would be my tip. Draw from your own experiences.
My name is James Burton. I've been a comic book creator probably since I was 5 years old. I used to draw naked ladies on chalkboards. But now I draw Damage Inc. I'm the creator that gets all these pretty pictures done. And I'm here with a tip for all new comic book creators. There's one thing that is more important than anything else. It does not matter how badass of an artist you are. It does not matter how badass of a writer you are. It does not matter how fast you get your stuff done if you don't get it done in the first place. So my tip is, finish the flipping book. When it's finished, you can have somebody come up and buy a book. When it's finished, you can send it out to people to get reviews. When it's finished, you can join awesome groups like Scattered Comics and get other stuff done. But if it's not finished, you can just sit there and think about it all day long. You can go to cons, talk to people, hey, I got this great idea. Great ideas don't matter. Getting the book finished matters.
Is there anything you have coming up soon that you want to talk about a little bit?
Yeah. Now, the next issue of Damage Inc. has got a lot more gritty artwork. Our work is black and white, and it's going to be awesome. It's going to be finished by the end of October, and I should have it out soon, as well as another Kickstarter coming right behind it.
Hey, I'm Scooter. I do some things with these guys, with Scattered Comics. Time to Tabletop, that's what I've been doing for now the last few years. Podcasts, anything kind of nerdy, but mostly a fanboy of pretty much everybody out there. Eli is doing some amazing things for the community, which is part of what we do. Enrichment classes for kids, we put on events. We work with as many game stores as we can because we're at A1 now. We work with all of them to try and get Scattered Comics into those game stores. So we have gotten them into the game room out in Elk Grove. We had them out there for a while. We're now at Comic Command Center with Scattered Comics. And, of course, A1. So little tip, I would say, as just a fanboy, do what you love. I mean, I think, you know, they always talk about the, do it. I can't do the Shia, but do it. But it really does come to that. I always say, pull the trigger. Let's do it live. But that one's been tainted, so we don't do that anymore. But I always say, pull the trigger, and that gets a little aggressive when I'm talking to schools. So just make it happen. I mean, if you have a passion or a love for something, or you have a story to tell, and you're thinking about drawing it, I freaking draw it. I mean, put the story in there. People want to hear it. You don't think people want to hear it? They may not actually want to hear it, but they might need to hear it. It might be the issue that you save the world by, or you're a little corner of the universe. That's me in a nutshell, and that's Fanboy 101.
I know you're doing stuff with Scattered Nexus.
Yes.
Could you?
Yes, I would love to.
You can go over there and talk with him about it.
Okay.
Well, this is the new, see, I haven't gotten the new print, so I'm excited.
Yeah, it's totally in beta still, so.
But it's amazing.
Yes.
Okay.
he's my connection to the gaming community, and he's a very powerful wizard when it comes to gaming, so he's doing his best to make sure that Scattered Nexus is the best that it could be, getting me the ins and outs. If you know me, you know I'm just doing a bunch of stuff, and I have no idea what's going on. So
so we connect on a couple levels.
Yes. So another important tip is network. Know your strengths and know other people's strengths, and that way you can create something more amazing and powerful than you both can separately. Wait.
Like your game?
Yes, like this game. Yeah, you'll like this game.
Big thing that I've learned, especially with this, is not just with the game, but with creating something, is knowing your strengths. If you know your strengths, you can overcome your weaknesses by using your strengths. They can help pull those up. That's something I learned a long time ago in some sort of management class. But it does work. And with this, this is what my favorite part about this. You can fight against each other, or you can co-op with each other. That's what I really love about it. I mean, I know you're working on the balance and stuff like that, but it is kind of fun to have an overpowered part every once in a while. but no, we really enjoy it. My daughters and I have played it. My son hasn't played it yet, but I've played it with you online. And I had a blast.
Yeah. Thank you. All right. And do we just walk off now? All right.
My name is Noel Serrato.
Noel, how long have you been a comic book creator?
About 10 years, a good 10 years.
Hmm. Wait, what year was that? 2008? Oh, nice. That's when I first started and failed.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I failed many times.
What? Tell us about the books that you create. What's the title?
Books that I create would probably be one book right now, which is Blimp.
Where are those? Do you have any blimps around? Or
could be something I'm holding on to.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. It should be one, two, three. These look familiar. Yes, Blimp 1, 2, and 3, and 4. 4 just came out.
Nice.
About a couple months ago.
That's awesome.
Yes.
And are you the writer, illustrator, both? What do you do?
Well, started off, the character was created by Jason back in the 1990s. You fast forward, there's a lot of story in the 1990s, what happened with the character, but that would be destroying the whole story. Why buy it if I just told you what happened to him?
No spoilers.
No spoilers, yeah. But, you know, most recently, about probably 5 years ago, he approached me with a cool story, a pitch of this character, and I had to do it. You know, it's one of those things where they appealed to me, and I liked it.
Nice. Awesome.
So you do the artwork and the writing of Blimp?
Right. Again, I'm sorry. Jason was the first person to actually start the book off with writing. He wrote the first book, and then followed by Ryan Taylor, jumped in on number 1, 2, and a little bit of number 4. I co-wrote some of the story just to get the timelines correct. And also, co-op with Eli Bird, who's doing this interview, you know, and we came up with some good ideas, and that's where we are now.
So book number 4 came out this year, right?
Yes.
When's book number 5 coming out?
It should have came out like today, but it didn't come out today.
So book number 5 is going to be soon.
It's ready. The writing that has been done, the writing has already... the only thing with the writing is I jump in with Eli's stories, kind of mesh them together and create an even better book than what the story was going to be.
You're going to make me blush.
Yeah, but the book is, the artwork is ready. It's just we're waiting for one process that's not done, the final edit, and it'll be good to go. But I wish I could say it's going to be out this year. It should have been out already, but we'll pray for the end of the year.
If you had one tip for like new comic creators, folks that are just beginning the process of creating comics, what would that tip be?
A new tip for any new?
A tip for like new comic creators, someone who's just getting into wanting to create their own comics.
Don't be afraid to fail. Don't try to be perfect, because if you're perfect, then you don't know how to get to the next level. I believe failure, or when you make mistakes, they only create success in the future. Mm-hmm. You know, that's the number one thing. Everybody wants to make everything perfect. They want to make everything look like the next, or the perfect book they grab off the shelf. Mm-hmm. It's great to compliment those things, but you know, you got to keep true to your art style. And grow with the art style as well. The mistakes, I throw a lot of mistakes in my book.
Yeah.
And my publisher, Jason, would, like, if he was right next to me, he'd be like, don't say this, but it's true. You know, like, he's like, I'm just going to clean that up. He's like, no, there was force there. I like that there. I like that mistake. Mm-hmm. And it's kind of like my niche, really. It's kind of like the fluidity of my art. I could erase all the lines and just be nice and crisp if I wanted to. Like my banner, I don't know if you see my banner right behind me. It's a lot of lines going on. I can just erase a lot of those things, and then people are like, oh, why'd you do that? That's your style. So my one advice would be, like, don't be afraid to make those mistakes. There's a lot of clarity with those mistakes. There's a lot of secrets with those mistakes. Own those mistakes, and it'll basically take you to the next level. Your level. But, you
know. All right.
Yeah. Is there anything that you want to plug?
Oh, scattercomics, you know, .com, you know, you got to do that. Jason killed me. But also the Patreon, too, Scatter Patreon. Check out those web, you know,
webcomics?
The websites and the vlogs, too, that Jason be doing, compiled with a lot of our videos, sketches, a lot of new stuff, new input. Scattercomics.com.
Okay, so my name is Ruth Sparks. I work for A1 Comics. I've been working for A1 Comics for 14 years. I'm the general manager or COO, depending on who you're talking to and what I need to get done that day. this is the first time we've done the 24-hour comic book event, even though it's been around for a long time, because we couldn't find a good way to do it, because 24 hours is a lot to ask for our staff and then for the people that show up. So Lanvin, our head of advertising, came up with the 4-hour comic idea, which I thought was really good. We weren't sure what to expect, because we've never done it before, and then we had about, I'd say, 20 people other than the creators show up today, so I'd say it was a pretty big success.
Yeah, absolutely. So let's see, do you have any tip for new comic creators? I know you're in a comic store, you probably have a sense of it.
So there's a couple of pitfalls I've seen people over the years fall into. One is they get discouraged really easily. Creators they tend to be sensitive and they want to have people's feedback on their art. But people are not easy to get interested in new art, especially if you're not drawing their favorite comic book character and they don't know who you are or what you do. They kind of ignore you, and so you kind of have to get a tougher skin early on and just get used to being ignored and rejected. I know that sounds harsh, but there's a lot of very talented artists I've seen that have gone under the radar for over decades, and then all of a sudden they'll have a hit and then everybody wants to know who they are. So you have to just tough through it, you know, and just work on making your art as best as it can be and kind of networking and getting out there.
That's a great tip. I wish I would have known that.
And you guys are located, how many stores do you have and where are they located?
So we have three physical locations. There's the one we're in right now, which is on in Roseville on Sunrise Boulevard, 818 Sunrise Boulevard, and then our Sacramento store, which is 5361 Auburn Boulevard, and then our newest store is in Folsom, that's 600 East Bidwell Street. And we also have an eBay store, so if you go to A1 Comics eBay, anything that is in that store, if you're interested in it, you can pick up at our Sacramento location and not have to pay shipping fees. We'll give you a 10% discount for saving us the listing fee and whatnot.
Baller.
Nice. Awesome. That's awesome. Is there anything else that you want to plug?
We're having a Halloween art and costume contest at the end of this month, which is always fun and creative. So we do participation prizes, which a lot of people don't know about. So if you're just on the fence, if you're going to dress up, or if you aren't sure if you want to show your art, you should just do it anyways and just be part of the community.
Awesome.
That's awesome.
Thank you.
No problem.
Thank you.
Thank you everybody for watching our video. Please check out these other cool videos you see on your screen. You can help Scattered Comics and its creators by going to the description below and purchasing any of our cool stuff. Give our video a like and don't forget to subscribe.